Today I'm making the basic cider mayo from the Poole's Diner cookbook. It's one of the sort of base recipes that a lot of other recipes use. And it's just a basic mayo recipe. We're going to put all of the ingredients except for the oil into the food processor, emulsify it, and then we add the oil and continue emulsifying. So that is, I've got all my ingredients already laid out, and I'm just going to get the egg yolk separated from the white in my food processor. I need a teaspoon of Dijon mustard. I'm just using Grey Poupon, which is what we always keep in the cabinet. And a half of a teaspoon of salt. She says to use sea salt. I'm just using the standard diamond crystal kosher salt that I always use for cooking. And this is the cider vinegar. And then all we have to do is blend that up for a bit and get it emulsified. I'm gonna grab spatula because I noticed there's definitely some stuff stuck. Some mustard got stuck to the side. You can make this without a food processor. It's a lot easier with. So get that all mixed up. And then you slowly drizzle in your oil. I'm using grapeseed oil because that's what I generally use when something wants a neutral vegetable oil. And it just takes some very small amount of time, well, a very long amount of time because you want to drizzle it really slowly to make sure it gets all emulsified. Stop and scrape down the sides. I don't think she tells you you have to do this, and you probably don't have to, but I just like to make sure it all gets mixed in and see how it's doing. See, I've got a little bit of egg yolk that wasn't quite mixed in. This is a KitchenAid mixer that we got when we got married almost 17 years ago, so it's been sticking with us that long and it's been a workhorse. Never needed repair, so that's good. Emulsify, and yeah, it didn't seem like it was thick enough, but it certainly is a nice mayo consistency. I'm gonna let it go just a minute, a little bit more after this, after I wipe it down this last time, and we'll have our basic cider mayo. I have a mason jar that I plan to just Now it's all done. Sink, and I'm gonna put this into a mason jar. I don't think you guys need to see that. So
you do.
You do? Okay. So I'm gonna put this in a mason jar. I have already prepared, washed out for this. Here we go. Gotta hold the blade so it doesn't fall out. It will thicken up, and it's homemade mayonnaise. This is used in several recipes. I believe the first one we're going to make is pimento cheese that includes this. I think it, she also uses this mayo for her deviled eggs. Just get as much as you can off the blade. I don't think it uses the entire recipe for pimento cheese, so we'll just have mayo you can use for something else. Maybe we'll make deviled eggs. All right. There we go. Basic cider mayo.